Hello, traders. I'm Jeremy Coleman. Now, in this video, I'm going to show you how to practice trading options using thinkorswim paperMoney, a virtual trading simulation platform that lets you practice trading without risking real money. And it's also a great way to learn how to use thinkorswim. Once we're logged in, I'm going to show you some key functionality that options traders should be familiar with. We'll start out with an option chain, and then I'll show you how to buy a single option, as well as how to enter a spread trade. And finally, I'll show you how to analyze a position's risk and reward using the risk profile on the Analyze tab. So let's jump in and get started. Now, each account does start with $100,000, and today we've selected the margin account. You could certainly select the IRA if that's the type of account you want to test out. We're going to go ahead and jump in to look at some options trading techniques in this platform. Come up here to the Trade tab. We're going to go here to the All Products sub-tab, and you notice the symbol box here is asking us to enter a symbol. I'm going to click in there. Go ahead and type in Microsoft, MSFT for this example. Press Enter on your keyboard, and that's going to pull up our option chain. Now, just to give ourselves a little more real estate here, we're going to go ahead and minimize the left sidebar. And now you can see along the top here, we have the price of Microsoft, last trade, $283.96. It's down $322. There's our current bid and ask. Below the stock there, we're going to see our option chain. And you can notice here some of these options are yellow, and some of them are white. Well, the yellow options are weekly options or non-standard expirations, and the white options are your standard end of the month option. Looking from the left to the right here, you can see we got the 21st of April of 2023. That is 16 trading days left, and you see actually as I hover over that, it tells you days until last trading day. And this contract is for 100 shares. That's a standard option contract. If you ever see something different here, it means it's been adjusted in some way. Now, to open the option chain, we're going to go over here to the left-hand side, click on that little arrow next to the date, and we're going to look at this option chain. In the center here, you notice we're actually only showing four strikes. That's the default setting here in thinkorswim. If we want to see more strikes than four, we can click there and go down through some preset quantities, or we actually can kind of select any quantity we'd like by deleting that number there and typing in a different number. We'll go ahead and type in 25 just as an example. You press enter after you do that, and now you can see our option chain is showing 25 strike prices. Now, the left-hand side of your option chain here is the calls, and the right-hand side is the put options. And over on the left-hand side and the right-hand side, you can kind of see there's this highlighted purple area. Well, those are your in-the-money options. As we mouse down over here to the black area, we'll see those are the out-of-the-money options. So these are your out-of-the-money calls. Now, placing a trade is actually quite simple on this platform. What we're going to do is pick our strike price. And for this example, we'll just buy a call option. Microsoft's down a bit, $283.95 now. So let's say we want to go ahead and buy the $285 call. Well, what I'm going to do is mouse over the ask price. You see it's $5.55 right now. And I'm just going to do a single left click on that price. That'll open our order entry tools down at the bottom of the platform. And you can see we've got a long green buy order. You see here it's just buy a single option. By default, there's a 10 contract quantity. And we have a date and a strike price. Again, it's a call. Now, 10 contracts might be a little bit large, so maybe we want to adjust the default. Very simple way to do that. We're just going to go ahead and delete this order temporarily. Come up here to the upper right-hand corner of the platform, and we're going to find this little gear wheel, and we're going to go ahead and select Application Settings. Now we're going to come up here to Order Defaults and go ahead and select Options. Now if you notice on the right, the default quantity of the orders right now is 10. I'm just going to go ahead and change that over to 1. Come down to the lower right-hand corner and click Apply Settings. I'm going to come back to that exact same call I was trading before and click on that. And guess what? This time it's one contract over there. Now let's follow this over to the right. 285 call. By default, we pull up a limit order for you, and we actually fluctuate that limit order with the ask price. You can see it's actually ticking along here at the bottom. Now if we wanted to put in a lower price than the current ask price, we can actually click in this field. You can highlight the numbers and type in a price, like $5. Enter. Or you can actually use the plus minus here to adjust your price. Let's go ahead and try to send this order as a limit order below the market at $5. We're going to keep it as a day order, but if you did want this order to last for longer than the trading day, you can click on that and switch it over to be good till canceled. Come down to the lower right-hand corner, find the confirm and send button, and then review our order one more time before we send it out, just to make sure we did everything right. We can see we're buying one Microsoft, April 23rd, 285 call at $5 limit order. I'm going to go ahead and click on send there. And now to check the status of our working order, we're actually going to want to move right up here to the monitor tab. And guess what? The activity and positions page now populated. And we're going to see we got a working order here. It is working at $5. The market price is $5.47. So unfortunately, we're not going to get filled on this, and maybe later in the day we would. So let's say we actually want to change the price and go ahead and get a fill. So what we're going to want to do is right-click on the order, and you can actually cancel it here, or you can cancel and replace it. This is how you can edit the order. So for this, I'm going to go ahead and click on Cancel Replace, and that's going to pull up a new order. You can see it's actually replacing the other one, adds a new order ID, same quantity, everything is the same, but we're going to go ahead and pull the price back to the market price, and that's done by using this little lock here. When that lock is locked, your price is going to stay the way you want it. If you want the price to fluctuate with the market, we're going to toggle that open, and you can see it moved me right back to the current market price. This time, I'm going to go ahead and click on Confirm and Send. Now that we replaced that order, let's go up here back up to the Monitor tab, and we'll notice that we actually have no more working orders, and we have a filled order. Let's go ahead and open up that filled order section. You can see that we did buy that option, $285 call, and we paid $5.25. If we mouse down over here, you can see that we also have a canceled order that was our one working there for $5. So now that we bought that option, let's go ahead and see how we can monitor the position. We're going to go down to the position statement. We're going to come over here to Microsoft. We're going to want to open up this section here so we can see our option. You can see we bought the $285 call. We bought one of them. We paid $5.25, and the current mark is $5.32. So that is giving us a little profit, both for the open since we bought it and for the day of $5. Next, I'm going to show you a little bit more of an advanced type of options order called a vertical spread. In order to do that, we're going to go back up here to the trade tab, and we'll use a different symbol. We'll just go ahead and use Apple. Go ahead and press enter there. And we're going to come back down to our option chain. Let's close up this expiration. Let's do this in a later expiration. We'll go out here to the 19th of May. Now I'm going to want to scroll down. Now again, I'm going to start with the option I want to buy. I'm going to mouse over the 160 call, and I'm going to go ahead and right-click on that option this time. When I right-click, you can see it brings up this menu here. You notice we've got a buy and a sell. We're going to do a buy spread here today. You look on the right, you can see there's various types of option spreads available to you. Again, like I said, we're going to go ahead and use the vertical spread today. I'm going to go ahead and click on that there. And now you notice we actually have two lines instead of one like before. It tells what type of spread we're doing here, a vertical. It shows one line for buy, one line for sell. Tells us we have the Apple option, 19th May, 160, 165 call spread. And now it pulled up 160 and 165 because by default, thinkorswim pulls up the next strike out of the money when we create a debit spread like this. If for some reason we want to widen out the spread, you actually can click on the lower option here, 165, change it up to 170. And what you might notice here is that our debit price changed directly with that. Platform is calculating this debit based on buying the 160 and selling the 170, automatically creating that. If we look down below here, you can see we are currently on the mid price. And if you want to see the natural price, the bid ask price of this spread, you can go over here and look at it's $5.15. This is a limit order. We're going to keep it good for the day because we're going to try to get a fill here. I'm going to go ahead and click on confirm and send. Review this order. You can see we got our vertical spread here, 160, 170 call. And we got our break even, maximum profit, maximum loss listed as well, just in case you want to check that out. I'm going to go ahead and click on send and wait for our fill. And there you go. You can see the order just filled. Now let's go back up here to the monitor tab. Click on that. You can see we actually got our fill here. You can see each individual leg's fill price and the total debit of $5.10. Now I'm going to show you how to close out this position. So we paid $5.10. We're going to come down again, find Apple in our position statement. Go ahead and open that up, and you'll see we have the 160 call and the 170 call here. Now to close out the spread, what you're going to want to do is drag your mouse over both strikes, and you can actually then right-click, and we're going to go up here to create closing order. Now if you notice, there's three different ways that the platform is suggesting we close this out. You can see the first one is to sell it as a vertical. The second one here would be to buy back the single, the 170 call, or sell the long 160 call. Now, for this example, we want to just use selling the vertical spread. I'm going to go ahead and click on that there. And you can see it actually takes us back over here to the trade tab with the exact opposite trade to close out our spread. Now, let's say we want to get a little bit of a profit on this possibly. So we're going to go up here and click and change our credit price that we want to receive to sell this option to $7. We're going to go ahead and press enter. You notice you set that in. Now, it might take some time for it to reach $7, so we want to make sure this order is going to be good till canceled, which means that's going to continue to work until it fills or we cancel it. Now, I'm going to click on confirm and send, and then you'll notice here we can review the order one more time just in case we want. We'll click on send, And I always like to just double check that that order is still working by going back up here to the monitor tab, and you can see we are working for a $7 credit. Mark price is $5.15. Okay, next is an area of the platform I think every option trader should know how to use. It's the Analyze tab, the Risk Profile. What we're gonna do is go up here to the Analyze tab at the top of the platform, select Risk Profile, and what we're gonna wanna do here is enter a symbol, and we'll use the same symbol of what we just did that spread for. So I'm gonna go ahead and type in Apple, press Enter, and you'll notice it pulls up this graph here of two different colored lines. We have a pink line and a blue line. What this is showing is us the risk of the spread we just placed. The pink line is actually representing profit or loss, and so is the blue line. These are just profit and loss on two different days. If I mouse over the middle here, this is the current price of Apple, you can see in the lower left-hand corner, the pink line represents 4/5/23, and the blue line represents our expiration date of 5/20/23. Now, at the moment, we're not making really profit or loss on this, but if the stock stayed exactly where it was at expiration, we'd be losing $251.26. Now, this was a bull vertical spread we placed. That means we want the stock to go up. If it goes up and actually crosses over this point right here, which is our break even, that's the strike price plus the premium that we paid, and continues past that all the way up here to the top where it plateaus, you'll see our maximum profit in the lower left-hand corner is $490. Now, if the stock moves against us here, goes down, 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 crosses break even again, and continues down all the way to the bottom plateau, you'll see we're at our maximum loss of $510. Now, notice that there's three dotted lines here in the middle. This line here is the current price. We have a lower end here, which is 10% decrease in the stock price, and this upper end, that's 10% increase. Now, the reason I know that is I actually come down here to this price slice section, and you'll see we have three lines here that also correspond with these three dotted lines. Now, one thing I always like to show is how to check our probability of profit on a spread. This break-even point, we need the stock to be above that to break even. The platform has a really neat little tool here where we can follow this over to the right-hand side and find our menu button. Click on that, and we're gonna go ahead and go to Set Slices. Gonna go over here to Break Even, mouse over and select the expiration date, because that's the one that's most important to us today, not just today. When I click on that, you'll see our three lines disappear, and we now have one line directly across our break-even price. Now, on each side of this line, we have a percentage, 41.63, you see it might change a little bit, and 58.29. This means that we have a 41.5% chance of making a profit, a penny or more on this spread, and a 58% chance of losing a penny or more. Very, very powerful tool to help you understand your risk to reward, probability, on a vertical spread. Next, I'm gonna show you another really cool feature of thinkorswim around options trading. We're actually gonna navigate back up here to the trade tab, back to the all products sub tab. And just for the purpose of this, we're gonna go ahead and minimize this option chain. And we're gonna locate down here where it says today's option statistics. Go ahead and expand that. Now, what the platform does here is gather data about all the options that are being traded today. You can see we have call volume and put volume. We have what prices calls and puts are being traded at, whether they're trading at the bid or lower, or at the ask or above, or maybe they're being traded between the market. We have extensive information over here about volatility, 52-week high IV, 52-week IV low, IV percentiles, even a VWAP. If you follow that over to the right-hand side, you can also see we have information about how unusual these options are trading. This is called the Sizzle Index. Really, really valuable information, a wealth of information about the options being traded today, all at your fingertips. Now, lastly, another really cool feature of paperMoney is we have the ability to adjust a position. So let's say we made a mistake when replacing a trade or we no longer want that option in this account. We're actually gonna go back up here to the monitor tab. I'm gonna scroll down here to our positions. Let's say we made a mistake here. We bought this Microsoft call and we messed up. We don't want it in our account anymore. Well, we can go ahead and right-click on that, and you'll notice there is a little section here that says Adjust Position. If I click on that, what it's going to do is pull up this area where I can actually change this quantity. Now, we bought this call option, so how do we get rid of something that we own? We want to do a negative quantity that will offset that. Now, when we bought this, we paid, where is it? $5.25. It actually came up right here. So you're going to want to put in the exact opposite, the exact same price you paid for when you sell this. And I'm gonna go ahead and press Enter, and you'll notice here I can click OK, and guess what, that is gone. Now it does take overnight for this position to reset, So tomorrow when you pull this up, that Microsoft position will go away completely. Now, another thing we can do with paper money is make adjustments to the account. If you look over here on the right-hand side, we have this adjust account button. When you click on that, we have several different choices. We can actually reset everything. Click that box and click apply. That resets you all back to the $100,000 account values, gets rid of all the positions. Again, does take overnight to reset completely, but all these will go away. Now, another thing we can do here is actually change the amount of money we're starting with. You know, if you remember, both of these accounts started with $100,000. Well, let's say we want to start with a smaller amount than that. You can actually click on this dropdown. You can see we have some default choices, $25,000, $50,000 increments, but maybe we just want to pick an arbitrary number, $10,000. Well, what we're going to do is we're going to highlight this number right here. We're going to type in 10,000. We're going to press enter. I'm going to go ahead and click apply. And guess what? When we look up here at the top, we have $10,000 in this account now. Now remember, paper money is just a simulation, and it'll vary in many respects to trading in your live account, specifically for options traders. Remember, as the bid-ask spread widens, your paper money platform will probably give you a fill somewhere in the middle of the market. So if you're backtesting or trying to test a potential strategy, remember you're getting more favorable fills in paper money, and those numbers should never be relied on as future success of that strategy. So always keep that in mind. Now also, the paper money platform will not assign a short option position early, and that's also different from trading in a real account. If you're looking for more great investor education, check out Insights and Education on Schwab.com. And don't forget, check out all of our great content on our YouTube channel.